Alrighty, welcome to another Vintage Cube Supreme Draft here on channelfireball.com, and these are a little funny. So the way these work is you open 18 packs, take two cards out of each pack, and that's your deck. You get to build it however you want, of course, but since you only draft 36 cards, you're not cutting that many cards. And honestly, I found these to be a lot of fun. They're pretty wild, and as we go through it, you'll kind of see how that plays out. First of all, cards like Fourth Year Lingus. Well, Fire Comps is kind of okay, but Fourth Year Lingus or Life Death, nothing like that. You basically want to take all really cheap blue cards and go pretty busted. I'm going to take Brain Freeze for sure, and I think Paradoxical Outcome. I think PO is pretty good. You end up with a lot of power, and I'll slam those two, and oh, there's a Mana Crypt. That's a great sign. And then Mystic Confluence versus Underground Sea is kind of close, but I think I'm going to go with the Confluence just because card counters are good when you start to play the mirrors, which you're mostly going to be doing, especially as people have kind of gotten the hang of how these work. You're trying to go as busted as possible, as soon as possible, and don't want to play any creatures, don't want to play any red cards, green cards, or really any white cards. This pack is actually really bad, but I guess Jace Wielder Mysteries is a nice win condition, so I will take that. The next pack, I don't want Thopter Foundry in my deck. I could see Balance. Go to zero cards. I'm not thrilled with it, really, but I don't see myself wanting to play many of these other cards. I guess you could make an argument for Creeping Tar Pit just because it's a blue-black land, but I really don't want to play tap lands. I'd rather just take Jace and Balance. Even if I don't end up playing Balance, that's fine. Well, Spell Pierce is definitely good. I'll be happy to take that. And then the next card. Wow, this is another pack of cards I don't really want. I think I'm just going to take Spire Bluff Canal. There is a chance that I want that. I don't like Portal. I don't like Ulamog or anything. Okay, Time Spiral's not bad. Definitely want Lotus Petal. And I think I will go with Time Spiral. It's a little bit on the expensive side, but it is a pretty strong card. So I think I'll take that. And then here, well, I definitely want Frantic Search, and I'm trying to see what the next card would be. I don't really want Zagoth Triumph all that much, but I guess I could see going there. There's also Sensei's Divining Top, which can be nice with something like Balance, Jace, Paradoxical Outcome. All right, I'll take Frantic Search and Top. There's also Roggevon. Yeah, you know what? Roggevon is actually kind of interesting. I'll do Roggevon and Frantic Search, but I definitely want the Frantic Search. All right, well, I definitely want Mox Sapphire as well, and I think Grim Monolith is going to fit nicely into this sort of deck. So I will take that over Jace Vryn's Prodigy. Just artifact mana is at a premium. Polluted Delta is decent. Vampiric Tutor as well. Yeah, I guess I could take those two. There's also Displacer Kitten. Maybe I just do Displacer Kitten Delta and try to limit black cards, and I'll just try to pick up a duel to make it so Delta works here. Remand is just okay. Mox Opal's great. The reason I say Remand is just okay is that it is a little bit weak against other cheap spells, but I still think it's probably good enough. All right, I'll take the Remand and the Opal, and then I'll definitely take Ancestral, and I think Demonic Tutor. Demonic Tutor is still pretty good. Minsk and Boo, Atroxa, these are just cards I don't think you really want to play. Oh, I like Mox Jet. We're getting there on Moxes. Finally, we started pretty slow in terms of power, but we're getting there. And Urza. Urza is also really good because you have so many Moxes in your deck. Narset is fantastic. So right now, the non-blue cards I have are a balance, a DT, and a Roggevon, which I may or may not be playing. Definitely going to take Narset. And I think I'll take Currency Converter. Well, it's that or Spellseeker. Actually, Spellseeker is probably better. Currency Converter is a little bit slow. Gives you something to do, though. Actually, you know what? Spellseeker is actually a little bit expensive, so I'll take Narset and Currency Converter. I'll just go for the cheap artifacts. Ooh, I do like a Black Lotus. Oh, and Orcish Bowmasters. This is one of the few black cards. DT and Bowmasters are like the only black cards I like in this format, but I'll be happy to slam those. There's Chromatic Star, Jace, yeah, nothing good doing with any of those. Here, the format is way too fast for Upheaval to be good. I could see Bolas's Citadel because that does line up nicely with Tinker, but actually, I don't mind a Lightning Bolt. It might seem odd, but Lightning Bolt does kill Roggevon, Hull Breacher, Orcish Bowmasters, and those are important things to kill. And I think I maybe will just take the Citadel in case I see the Tinker and not worry about balance. Library is okay, and Urza Saga is okay. I guess I will take those, but I'm not thrilled by the prospects. And then here, I'm definitely going to take Mox Diamond. And I guess this actually is a Xander's Lounge deck. Yeah, all right. Well, I can buy that. I don't really care too much about missing Lorien Revealed. The Lorien Revealed would be good with Force of Will. Force of Will is also an amazing card in this format. So, what do we want here? We've got Force of Will. Tinker is not looking like very likely. There's Metamorph, which isn't ideal here. Mind Twist can be good. Yeah, I'll do Force of Will Mind Twist. And then the last pack here. Oh, we got another Mox. And there's Fable of the Mirror Breaker. Trinket Mage. I don't care about Walking Ballista. Pented Prism's just okay. I mean, Fable is still a pretty strong card, and I guess I do have the mana for it. So, all right, I'll go those. All right, so going to deck building here. I think I can cut the balance. I didn't get any white fixing anyway, really. And then I don't mind most of this stuff. Paradoxical Outcome is definitely great. Displacer Kit, oh, Bulls of Citadel can go. Displacer Kitten, I don't think is critical. So right now, if I add 6 lands, I'll have 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 lands, kind of. I could go one more land if I can cut one card. Mox Diamond's going to be a little dicey, but you know what? And you draw a lot of cards. Though I guess this deck doesn't have Wheel of Fortune or Time Twister. Interesting. I like Jace as a win condition. I guess, no, I think Displacer Kitten is probably good enough. I like Spell Pierce. I like Grim Monolith. Oh, I guess Frantic Search actually could go. All right. That seems like the one to cut. And 5-1-1? Yeah, that sounds about right. All right. Let's do this, and let's head into round one here and see how it goes. All right. Time for round one. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to mulligan this hand. This hand I like. Definitely keeping. I think I put back Lotus Petal. The reason is Mox Diamond plus Currency Converter is actually a pretty strong combo. So I want to keep both the Mox Diamond and both lands. Put it to 5 here. The disadvantage of giving up Lotus Petal is I could Mind Twist for 3 on turn 1 here. But I'm pretty sure I just want to go turn 1, Currency Converter, Mox, discard the land, and then use Currency Converter. And then turn 2, cast a big Mind Twist here. They only have 3 cards in hand. Let me see. Did they? Oh, I drew Spell Pierce. They did shuffle, but drawing Spell Pierce goes a long way for me wanting to wait, because I can just Spell Pierce whatever they play next turn. And I will play the Mox as well. In general, when you're playing this format, you should just play out your Moxes, because the odds that they cast a draw 7 the next turn are fairly high. I guess Spell Pierce doesn't really help against Lion's Eye Diamond, funnily enough. Okay. Oh, it does help against Tinker, if that's what they're doing. Or does it Metamorph? Sure. I guess I can't stop Metamorph. Wow, this makes the Mind Twist a lot worse now that they have Currency Converter here. Mox Opal? Yeah, I think I will Spell Pierce the Opal. Spell Pierce is getting a lot worse here. So it feels worth it. And I'm going to go ahead and put current treasure in my their island, my graveyard, to make a treasure. Not loving this Mind Twist. Oh, Time Spiral. All right. Well, let's draw a card and then discard a card. I think I'll just discard the Mind Twist and make a rogue out of it, then play a land, then pass. And then maybe I can go Time Spiral next turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, seems pretty reasonable. So they're going to use Currency Converter here and go up to 3 cards, discard. Yeah, if I draw a land, I think I'm just firing off Time Spiral. Oh, one thing I also didn't hit get in this particular deck is Talarian Academy, because that one's also pretty nice. Let's see. Oh, a Mox also works. All right, yeah, let's just run it. let's run it and hope that, actually, hold on. I'm going to put Mind Twist in my graveyard because I actually want that to be shuffled back in. I think drawing Mind Twist here would be fine. Did I miscount? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, I don't think I did. Weird. All right, there goes Time Spiral. We're attempting to untap those two lands. Okay. I mean, if they don't have a counterspell here, then we're going to go pretty hard because I get to go Grim Monolith into Paradoxical Outcome. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cards. Well, let's see if this works. If they have to have Spell Pierce or Force of Will or Force of Negation. But if they don't, then I'm liking where we're at. And if they do, well, they have the Force. All right. Land, and I guess I'll Ancestral myself. So I guess maybe I should have done that first. Oh. I will not play the Mox here. Here, if I get Time Twisted or something, I don't really care too much, and I might want the Storm Count for Brain Freeze. Chromo Seed Shark. Yeah, that's just the kind of card I don't think you should put in your deck mostly. It's not crazy because of like Urza, but I just don't think you're going to end the game by attacking with Seed Shark tokens. Though I guess if you have Urza or Academy, this does do some work. Okay, so on my next turn, I'm going to Narset and hope to hit. Well, if I draw Displacer Kitten, Narset becomes really good. Narset, I mean, just generally pretty good against most of the decks here. I only have the one draw seven. I already used it, and Paradoxical Outcome, I guess, is my like backup draw seven. So I don't have a lot left in terms of that. Let's cast the Narset. Let's see what Narset has to offer. Oh, they have a counterspell? That's a shame. Draw with the Currency Converter, I guess. Okay, well, Displacer Kitten, I guess, doesn't really have much to do with Narset getting countered. All right, I'll play my land, and I guess I'll just pass the turn here. What I can do with Displacer Kitten is play a Mox, untap Grim Monolith, use Currency Converter, play a Lotus Petal, flicker Currency Converter, and like just kind of go that direction. But obviously I'm not thrilled by the prospect. Sensei's top. Yeah, I mean, they can animate these things, but I just don't think we're that close to winning that way. They pitched Spellseeker. Okay, I was just checking. Well, could use, I mean, Urza would be pretty sick. Anything that I can flicker for value with a Displacer Kitten will be worth a lot here. All right, happy enough to block there. Draw. Remand isn't terrible. Displacer Kitten. See what they've got. Probably nothing, but oh. Remand. Do I want to remand back? I don't think I need to do that. That's fine. I'll just play Displacer Kitten again. And doesn't matter which Mox I tap. And then I will play the Sapphire. Oh, they're going to spin the top here. Look for some kind of answer. Oh, they're drawing a card with Currency Converter. And discarding. They have another counterspell? No, I don't think so. All right, Mox. Displacer Kitten, the Grim Monolith. And then let's first put a Currency Converter treasure into the graveyard. Spell Pierce the Mox. Sure, that's fine. So they did have another counter. I don't really care about that. Let's put the island in the graveyard to make a treasure, and then go Kitten, flicker, Currency Converter. I guess Brain Freeze would be lethal, so I should probably use the Currency Converter, and then I'll still be able to remand if I need to. Draw. Yeah, library's not doing much for me. All right. I guess I'll just pass the turn here. I'm not that close to, I'm not even close at all to dying to the stupid sharks. I guess there are 9 from mostly this ancient tomb. So got to keep that in mind. They have a lot of counter spells, I will say that. Force, Mana Drain, Remand, Spell Pierce. And I get to remand something. Oh. 3 blue mana off Lion's Eye Diamond in order to make 2/2. Okay. Fine with me. I mean, Remand's mostly just going to cycle here. Well, no, they're playing something expensive, so I guess that's not entirely true. 4th Aerolingus. Okay. So they're playing more of a control deck, it kind of feels like. And let's flicker the Grim Monolith. And draw off Remand. Lightning Bolt. We're like strangely close to being able to win. In fact, if they attack for 4, I go to 14. Actually, there's a decent chance I'm going to kill them with Lightning Bolt. That's really funny. Because I hit them to 5, and then they might 4th Aerolingus down to 3. We'll see. Oh, they're drawing a card so they can play a land. No, they're just drawing a card. Interesting. Oh. Brain Freeze, huh? Let's draw and discard, I guess. Discard Polluted Delta. And yeah, they don't have any mana. Send with this thing and pass the turn. I'm not that close to dying to their random stuff here. They can make a treasure token end of turn. They draw Sensei's Divining Top. Also, if they play too many spells, I could Brain Freeze them. I don't think they're going to tap Ancient Tomb here, because it would be a little bit ambitious to do so, but you know, stranger things have happened. Actually, they might be dead. If they 4th Aerolingus, then they attack for 8 here. Oh, they're not even going for the lethal with the thing. Then I could force them to tap it with Displacerkin. All right, I'll take 6, going down to 8. They become the Monarch. 1 spell played. I guess I'll just take my turn after that. Okay, Seed Shark. 2 spells played. Yeah, we're not into Brain Freeze decking territory, but if we draw the right card, we could be. Oh, Raghavan. Wow, I guess that actually does it. Dash Raghavan. This is so funny. Attack with both. They have to use Ancient Tomb to animate one of the incubators. And then I just bolt them. what a funny game. Target the Currency Converter, and then I guess I'll draw a discard with Currency Converter. Just because there's no real reason not to. Oh. Guess I'll discard the Brain Freeze because I have a Spell Pierce here in case I needed it. Flicker the Converter. And bolt you, and that's game one. Oh, I guess showing them the Brain Freeze was foolish, but whatever. Matter too much. Do I want balance? Probably not. It's not great against Seed Shark. It's not even that good against 4th Aerolingus. I think we're good how we are here. Going to game 2 here. What a funny game 1. Let's see what we got. By the way, as always, this video is brought to you by Ultimate Guard, the sponsor of Team CFB. See him on the jersey here. And I think Ultimate Guard easily dominates the competition when it comes to quality sleeves and deck boxes. I love using katanas. I love using archives, and I highly recommend them. So check out Ultimate Guard, ultimateguard.com, of course. Now, as for this hand, exceedingly slow for this kind of format, but any hand with Forcible is probably pretty good. I think I will keep this. I don't love it, but if I draw a Mox or anything that gets me a turn 3 Urza, turn 2 with a Mana Crypt, honestly, then that plus Force of Will seems pretty strong to me. Okay, we'll keep this hand. Opponent also kept 7. Turn 1 Ponder, sure. Turn 1 Ponder. What is my best draw? I mean, I guess Ancestral Recall is probably the card I would most want to draw. I wouldn't even cast it immediately. I would kind of wait to see what they do, but okay. Mox is fine. Oh, Mox Diamond. Yeah, I will play that. Discard him, I think. I don't have very many red or black cards in my deck, so I don't really need to do too much more. Oh, Urza's Saga is not bad. Forensic Gadgeteer. I think I will have to force that, sadly. Pitch Mystic Confluence. Every time they play an artifact, they get a clue, and their clues only cost one to crack. That card seems pretty good in this format, honestly. So they're going to get to make a Saga token, but if that's their plan this turn, I don't mind too much if I can resolve an Urza here. Oh, I do like Orcish Bowmasters. I will resolve Urza first because it's more mana. And hope to draw Lotus Light next turn for a good time spiraling. All right, so you make a 2-2. You draw, probably make another thing. If you don't make another token here, you have a better spell to play, which worries me a little bit, but my board is okay, and we'll see. I mean, yeah, obviously they get to get Lotus and they get to make a big play here. So I'm not like loving the situation, to say the least. Five mana. Could this be a Mystic Confluence or something? I'm not sure. Oh, the One Ring. That's not so bad given this Bowmaster here. They do have Mana Drain. I do have to respect that. Chromox. Okay, are they casting a draw 7? Or no, they just want to make their construct as big as possible. Oh, they are pitching a card, though. Huh. I mean, they have a lot more stuff in play than I do. They're pitching Wheel of Fortune? What is happening here? Are they casting a draw 7? Oh, they're casting a Memory Jar. Okay, yeah, I'll take 5. I guess I'll just draw and see what I got here. That doesn't do anything, so I just pass. Nothing for me to do right now. One Ring. I think I'm going to let the One Ring ability resolve if they use that first, because I really want a Bowmasters in response to Jar. And hope they don't have Mana Drain. No. Hardcast Force. Yeah, all right. I can't do anything about that. Can I draw Brain Freeze? That would be a nice one. Okay. Definitely possible that they do something. Also, that kind of blanked their Jar. Like, they're not playing very many cards if that's their Jar turn. I think I'm still going to Brain Freeze them for 12 here. Let's see. I can block and bolt that after I get my things back. Yeah, that's probably good. I don't really want to take too much more damage off this. I'll block. I'll Brain Freeze you because I'm not playing any more spells. This makes the One Ring a lot worse as well. I mean, they might have a draw 7 or a reshuffle left in their deck. Oh, they have Force Negation also. Funny. But if they do, they do. All right. And my token dies. If they played a Mox, it would be really funny because that would actually be bad. But then I'll bolt their token. And if I draw a land, I could use Urza. All right. I don't really think attacking is going to help much, so I'm just going to pass. They're drawing with the One Ring. Okay. I kind of just wanted to draw a land so I could use Urza there, but this is okay. There are 5 cards in deck. I don't really know what they have left to kill me with. If they have a Time Twister or a Time Spiral, they can reshuffle. These decks are pretty light on win conditions, so it is possible getting their Urza and all that. All right, they're going into one card in deck. Yeah, they might just not have a way to win now. I mean, I guess we'll find out. Okay, maybe they have their own Brain Freeze. What is this for 6 mana, 7 mana, 10 mana? Oh, this is just a gigantic 4th Eorlingus that I'm going to remand. X equals 8. Yeah, I guess drawing remand was probably pretty good. Spell Pierce does not get the 4th Eorlingus, unfortunately. And so now their Mana Vault's not untapping, and that's pretty huge. Oh. I will Ancestral Recall you. Go ahead and draw 3 cards, please. And that is round 1. I think their deck was actually better than ours, but you know what? We'll take it. We take those. Alrighty, time for round 2. Ooh. I'm on the draw here, but this hand's got some potential. Anytime you open a Library of Alexandria, even in this format, it's great on the draw. And Library with Lotus, Bowmasters, Remand, Brain Freeze, all effective win conditions. If you notice that last game, I basically just cast Brain Freeze. I didn't really do anything else. I guess I did Ancestral, and then the Remand kept me from dying. But I didn't think I need the Ancestral. Because they the Mana Vault not untapping, they weren't going to be able to cast a 4th Eorlingus for enough damage. Well, Spell Pierce doesn't help because of Lion's Eye. But I did draw the Ancestral. So that worked out nicely. All right, my opponent mulled to 6 and doesn't have the turn 1 discard. Nice. Oh, has the turn 1 box, though. All right, let's go Library. Draw to 8. Play Lotus. I think it's way better to have a Lotus in play here. Just in case, I mean, I might need to cast Remand. I might need to cast Brain Freeze. I might want to cast Bowmasters. All of those seem legit. Your own Lotus. Good play, good play. Into Turok Dread Cantor. That's kind of annoying. I think I'm actually going to Remand it. They can't really cast it again very easily. And I want to keep this Library going. Oh, my Library is no longer going. Are we playing against a Black Disruption deck? That's kind of cool. I actually think that's a little neat. I just think it's neat. Let's just pass in on upkeep Ancestral here. Just because I don't want them to be able to counter it. And I want to fire off Ancestral before they maybe make me discard it. Graveyard Trespasser. Nice. You hit the Lotus or the Ancestral? Looks like the Ancestral. Draw. Urza's Saga. That's a pretty good land to play. Mox. Mox. I think I will play the Currency Converter and pass the turn here. Take 3 off the Trespasser. If you've got a black source, you can Turok me. But with a Currency Converter in play, it kind of doesn't matter that much. Yeah, sure. Got Mystic Confluence and Bowmasters. Yeah, I mean, that's like a little annoying, but I don't care too much here. Attack, and I guess I will just take it down to 17 here. End of turn, I suppose I just make a 2-2. Well, actually I can make a 2-2 later. I'm just going to draw and discard a card. Do I want to discard? I think I just discard Brain Freeze. That's not really how this is gonna pan out. I hope it makes the Turok bigger. Funny. Didn't really think about that. Let's bolt the Graveyard Trespasser and discard an island, which kind of gets... Now I knew I was making Turok bigger, by the way. Now I kind of get a rebate, though, because the discarded card goes under the converter. Yeah, they're not beating Converter plus Saga. And this actually looks like a balanced matchup, but I guess I'd have a really bad... I don't even have Pearl. No, balance is just too hard to cast. We're just going to fire it off. I do think it's interesting that I'm actually playing on someone who's trying to a different strategy. It's a worse strategy than the one I'm doing, which is why this is what most people do in this format. But it is interesting, at least. I just think Disruption's not that good against, like, Ancestral Recalls. This hand goes badly pretty easily, but I also think I'm not supposed to mulligan. Look, if they go turn 1, discard your Mana Crypt, then yeah, so be it. Okay, maybe their strategy's not that different than normal, but they did have like Scrubland and Turok and Graveyard Trespasser in deck. Yeah, the thing is, like, any hand I have where they go turn one Time Walk, turn two Inquisition you, like, not going to have great results. Oh, yeah, that's pretty good. I guess I'll just chill with this. No Bowmasters, please. Thank you. And let's see what they got. Spellseeker. I'm going to let them Spellseeker. I just don't think they're going to Spellseeker for like a Spell Pierce. They got Ancestral. Okay. I'll allow it and I'll Ancestral in response. In case I draw Force of Will here. I did. Nice. I'll Force your Ancestral. Pitching. I think Displacer Kitten. Both Displacer Kitten and PO are pretty bad. But that was pretty nice. Drawing Ancestral to force their Ancestral. You love to see that. You hate to see the lack of red mana here. But so it goes. They have not very many cards in hand. I hope I'm not getting Fallen Shinobied here. No? All right, what's your follow-up? They have a lot more mana than me. Oh, Mox? Yeah. I'll play the Mox. Play Narset. I am going to use the Narset if I get the opportunity. Reprieve, sure. Pass the turn. Still not feeling like great about this because my hand has just kind of a lot of bricks. Pitch casting Grief. So I guess you're animating it is the idea. Okay. Oh, is it from the catacomb? No. And then Mind Twisting. All right. So we both have no cards in hand. They have one more land than me and a Spellseeker, but I get the first draw step. Yeah, that's actually really not even that bad. The pitch cast Grief really lessens the impact of the whole thing. Well, ripping Shieldra directly after is pretty good, though. I guess I drew... Oh, man, Spell Piercing Mind Twist will be nice if we go to game three. DT is not great, given that I can't cast it. I guess I should actually not auto-yield, given I have Spell Pierce, but they're just going to cast Shieldra this turn. Am I supposed to be playing like one more red or black source? It's definitely possible. All right. Oh, we're done here. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. I'll actually play one more red because I guess I don't have a Mox Ruby, but. For the most part, I don't think I'm changing much. All right, I would like to play first. Oh, yeah, I will keep this hand. Turn one Currency Converter is just kind of game against them. Like, I could even play turn one Raghavan, but I think Currency Converter is harder for them to beat. So I'm going to play the Converter and play Mox Opal. They just have Inquisition, Grief, Mind Twist. Just, yeah, make me discard a card. That's fine. doesn't really do anything with a Converter in play. Okay. Well, this is obviously a lot of mana on turn one. This Turok? Yeah, sure. All right, Turok me. What did you get? Narset and Mountain. Okay. And now I'm going to make a treasure. And now my Mox Opal's on. Oh, Urza. Let's just go Demonic Tutor, and I think Ancestral. It's got to be right at this point in the game. Ancestral myself. Oh, Saga. Mox Jet. Nice. And then now I can use the Currency Converter in a variety of ways this turn. Saga also is a card they seem ill-equipped to deal with. And then I'm going to get attacked. Maybe they have like a Vindicate or something. Reprieve is the only white card we've seen so far. And do I want to use Currency Converter or what? Spellseeker. Okay. That does ruin any Raghavaning plans. Next turn, I want to activate Saga. And I think I will Currency Converter draw here. It makes Turok bigger, but Raghavan's not doing anything anyway. Grim Monolith's interesting. Land. Oh, Mana Crypt? Oh, okay. Let's just get Urza down. And then I can use Currency Converter and Urza Saga. I don't even really need to play the Grim Monolith. I don't think that does anything for me. This looks pretty good. They get to Ancestral here, but I haven't really played anything that goes over the top. Shieldred's, I guess, the card I'd be the most scared of. But even then, I'm going to have a bunch of like 7/7, 8/8 constructs. Yeah, they need something pretty good. They have Pest Infestation or something like that. They're tapping. They have a Green Mox. Maybe that does something. They could always Time Walk. Oh, Deep Cavern Bat. Yeah, I don't really care about that very much. Probably have to take Grim Monolith, to be honest. They have the Time Walk. Yeah, they're going to have Time Walk here, I guess. But they're still not doing anything. They can't attack. It does let them use the rest of the cards in their hand. Teferi Time Raveler. Sure. Bounce Construct. Yeah, I will. I guess I don't have to tap them. I could just tap the Mox Jet for black, but yeah. All right. You spent 3 mana to kill my Construct token. I guess I'm okay with that. And Gix? Okay. I mean, I guess that hits. You can hit with Deep Cavern Bat. I think I'm still doing fine here. This was a great turn. They Ancestraled and Time Walked and all that. I'm actually going to chump the Turok here, because I don't really want to take more damage. And I don't want to trade a Construct token, given that the Constructs are about to be enormous here. All right, I want to flip. That's nice. Let's make another Construct. And what am I going to get here? Probably Lotus, right? I guess if I'm tapping Lotus multiple times, that no, let's just get the Sapphire, that's fine. Because I want to use Urza, spin Urza here. And see what I hit. Mind Twist. I don't even really want to play that. Let's get down to business here. Attack. I guess Gix is going to let them, if they have another black source, Gix is going to let them play a bunch of stuff off the top. All right, maybe they cooked here. Maybe they got something going. And I guess I'll keep Island in hand. No, I'll play. It's fine. No reason to discard a card and then have Turok get bigger, right? So they can play it. If they play a black source, they can discard their hand and draw and get play a bunch of cards off the top. That could be good. I mean, my deck doesn't have like that many cards that like do anything, but obviously it's probably better than anything else they could do. They're gonna get to discard 4 cards. All right. Let's see what you got here. Exile my top 4 cards. Top 5 cards. They hit Mox Remand. Yeah, that's kind of what I was talking about. They're now going to, I think, have to chump with... If they Remand, it goes back to my hand. They can't even really do that. Oh, oops. I was supposed to make a Currency Converter token. That actually is not great for me. Let's start by spinning Urza here. And Xander's Lounge. Not too impressive. Let's see. I attack with both constructs. They go to 4. Oh, I guess making the token didn't matter like tons, but it still wasn't good. Yeah, I mean, I will attack with both constructs. Still not attacking Teferi. I'm just going to take 16. Yeah, I guess so. They're at 4. I'm going to keep a card in hand. I'll just play the Xander's Lounge and I'll pass the turn. And then now they can use Gix again for 2, I guess. And then just hope. That's going to be their plan. Oh, they're just going to attack for one. All right. They go to five. They draw a card, go back to four. And here comes Gix. Discard two cards. And let's see what we got. You hit Island Displacer Kitten. Okay. I mean, the kitten does block, I guess. So they have a couple chump blockers now. All right. Now, if I make a 2-2, what does that do? These two get chumped by Gix and Turok. I'm just trying to think. I guess it's still... It's probably better to draw and discard than make a 2-2. I guess I don't get to attack Teferi. I kind of want to attack Teferi, but if I attack Urza... Yeah, no, let's make it 2-2. I'm going to get to see a bunch of cards with Urza, so I don't think I need to do that. All right. Time Spiral. I mean, I'm probably going to want to do that, but is that good? If I draw Lightning Bolt, it's great. If I draw, I mean, they have two cards they can play because they played a land. All right, yeah, let's go Time Spiral here. I feel like the odds that I can use the mana and do something are a lot better. And Narset. Okay, their Ancestral Displacer Kitten. Okay. I think this kind of ends up with me brain freezing them, maybe, but we'll see. I mean, I guess they can Deep Cavern Bat my brain freeze now. Well, they might have to take Ancestral, or they might want to take Ancestral. Okay. I actually don't know that taking Ancestral was great. All right, let's Narset. Oh. Lightning Bolt, Paradoxical Outcome. I mean, Paradoxical Outcome Brain Freeze seems like it's a safer way to go about things. I'm not actually going to be able to necessarily win with Lightning Bolt. Let's go PO on 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. I mean, probably 7 things. Yeah, I don't think that's fine. And then Lotus. Mox. Okay, well, it's funny how this game did end up getting comboed out, but it did look like my Urza token, my Saga tokens were going to get to attack for lethal. All right, that's 2-0. Let's get see if we can beat the finals. All right, on the play here in the last round. I'm willing to keep most hands where I just play a turn on library. On the play, obviously, it's like a little slower because you don't get to tap it the first turn, but you're on the play, so that part's nice. Library, go, and then draw island, have spell pierce up. Seems like a pretty legit place to win. Okay, then we'll do 6, and I'm just going to go library, go. What are you going to do? Island, that's kind of what you want to see when you went turn on library. Draw. The best part of your turn is the draw step. The second best part is the second draw step. We've already had one draw step, but what about another? Oh, the timing on that, really not chef's kiss. That's why upkeeping the Ancestral there would have been good for so many reasons. It wouldn't have been able to library. It wouldn't have had the mana for spell pierce. Everything. But yeah, we take those. I get to go up to 7 next turn, and then I'll library, and I'll probably just play a Xander's Lounge. Obviously, the exception to play all your Moxes in this format is when you have a library in play. Oh no, if I get discarded, if they cast like an Inquisition or Duress or something, then the library train would be off. I will draw. They have Bowmasters. Oh, interesting. So let's go Xander's Lounge. Currency Converter. And you know what? If I have to Force a Will, then library is off, and I'll just cast a Jace next turn. I'll probably Force Pitching Displacer Kitten. Entomb. Okay, I haven't seen anyone do reanimation stuff. That's kind of cool. I guess I'm just going to force the reanimate spell. They do indeed have one. Yeah. Force it, pitching Displacer Kitten. And hope they don't have another. Oh, nice. They did not. Draw. Oh, Mystic Confluence. Unfortunately, I can't cast that even with Mox, so I'm going to play the Jace. Kind of hard for them to have a counterspell if given they didn't counter the Force of Will. But you never know. And who am I supposed to mill? I have a Time Spiral in hand so I can reshuffle. I still probably mill them. Oh. I guess I'll play Lotus. Why not? And I'll play the Mox Opal as well. All right. I got Force of Will and Mana Leak with that mill. Nice. Cracking their Tarn. And I feel pretty good about this. The library drawing me a couple cards was great. I got Spell Pierce and Ancestral. Force was a 2-for-2 because they used Entomb first, and it's currently not doing too much. It's going to go after them. I feel like when I have Brain Freeze in my deck, there's a pretty decent chance I want to mill them. Oh. Mox Diamond's nice with a Currency Converter, but now I can just pass with Jace is like my own version of Library, and I have Mystic Confluence up as well. Hard cast Subtlety. So it's going to attack my Jace. It's like, I kind of don't care that much, but I guess I'm just going to do it because this lets me use all my mana. So I'll counter Subtlety and draw two cards. And then if they resolve an Archon, then I'll just Time Spiral and that'll probably be fine too. Okay. I mean, they just seem pretty low on resources. Yeah, they in fact were low on resources. All right. On to the next game. Actually, I should just add one mountain, I think. But go to the next game nonetheless. All right, this game, yeah, I'll keep this. I love Currency Converter. If you've watched my cube videos in general, you probably know that. And certainly, even in this format, it's been good. Even though it's funny because it's kind of a slow card, but it's been good nonetheless. Let's cast Currency Converter. And I played Delta because if I have to crack it for a blue to use Spell Pierce, I will. But if not, I can go get Xander's Lounge, which seems fine. Seems like a good place to go. Oh, are we battling over this? Are you spell piercing my Currency Converter? I kind of want to spell pierce back. I honestly don't love it because spell pierce is such a valuable card, but I don't really have much action if that happens. And my opponent mulligan to 6, so I just feel like there. One of the possibilities if I don't spell pierce is, yeah, we just both do nothing. And then I really wish I had a Currency Converter in play. That's the case. Let's just play the pedal. I know that with Brain Freeze in hand, I kind of want to save up spells, but I feel like with Currency Converter, I could like draw into Remand. That would be good. Someone could cast a draw 7, just all those things. All right, let's draw. That's also kind of interesting. I actually think I'll discard Lightning Bolt. Make a 2-2. Draw. Oh, Displacer. I'm just going to play a land. Yeah, I'll play the Displacer Kitten. That's fine. They can't hard cast Subtlety yet. It's not like Displacer Kitten does that much, but... Oh. I would actually rather it get mana leaked than remanded, but here we are. Okay. Mox it up. Imperial Seal. All right, so given that they cast Imperial Seal, I might just have to Brain Freeze them. The Brain Freeze, I don't like burning it because it's such a good card. Oh. Oh man, I really wish I had a land for that Mox Diamond. I think I want a PO here. It's just, if this works, I draw a bunch of cards. They have a counterspell to go with their Imperial Seal. I mean, oh, they have Force. Force pitching Subtlety. Okay. I guess I can't stop Imperial Seal, but if they're just Imperial Sealing for Ancestral, That's not too bad. Which, or show and tell. Oh, okay. So the last card's an Archon. Yeah, I guess I'll put Displacer Kitten into play. I'll sack the Rogue. And I guess I'll discard the Brain Freeze. We're pretty much not close to that. And then the Currency Convert is kind of protecting the Displacer Kitten here, which is funny. All right. Oh, Demonic Tutor. It's got to be pretty good. So cast Demonic Tutor. Look for the Mox. And I don't actually have a way to deal with the Archon. Oh, I guess I can Mystic Confluence the Archon. That's probably the best thing I could do. I'll get Mystic Confluence. I'll tap Mox Jet. I'll play Mox Diamond. Flicker the Mox Jet. untap the Mox Jet. Cast Mystic Confluence. Bounce, draw two. And then I might even be able to discard a land to the Mox Diamond here, which is funny. And then I guess I'll flicker the Mox Jet again, because why not? All right, draw my two cards here. Oh, so I am going to discard. I can Mind Twist for two. I guess that's probably worth it. It's funny that this was the follow-up. It puts Archon into the graveyard, which I know isn't ideal, but it also gets the last card out of their hand, which I think is probably worth doing. Their last card was Entomb, so I guess it kind of didn't matter. They were going to get a creature in their graveyard regardless. Maybe they can get an Echo of Eons now. They have something like that, a flashback card. Or they can thin their deck by entombing whatever, to, like a land or something, so they don't draw it. Yeah, they entombed a Black Lotus, sure. All right, well, now we're both at no cards in hand, except I have a Currency Converter. I have 5 mana to their 4, and I have Rogue and Displacer Token. But I feel like I'm in pretty good shape. Obviously, if they draw Reanimate right here, then that would be really bad for me. And, oh, Grim Monolith? It's kind of interesting. I still think I'm gonna Currency Convert. Urza is a lot better. All right. And I don't have the mana to use it right now. But Urza Currency Converter is also, or Displacer Kitten is also nice, though. Given that they're at 9, if I just cast Urza and they don't draw something, I'm probably just going to win. They could reanimate, go to 1, then they go up to 4. They're not, reanimate's going to stop being an out in a second here. Let's cast Urza. And send for 4. Don't really have anything to do. I could convert. I don't think I'm going to use the Currency Converter. I could draw a card and hope to draw a 0 drop, but it doesn't seem necessary. I'm going to show me they had 2 lands, and boom, that's a trophy. These are fun drafts. There's a lot going on in Supreme Cube, and it's in some ways it's like you're trying to draft. At least I try to draft like the same style of deck. But the game's actually just wild and fun. So I've been enjoying these. I hope you have too. As always, these videos are brought to you by Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFB, and of course, TCG Player, the best place to get anything you need Magic related or really any other card game on the web. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.